New Tesla 4680 battery is now unbeatable. An announcement caught people's attention during Tesla's last battery day in September of last year. The news was the announcement of a new type of cell called the 4680. Welcome to the channel. In today's video, let's take a look at the new Tesla 4680 battery. Musk claimed that it would increase the range of Tesla vehicles, provide more power, and be less expensive. And recently, the company released an update, and by the looks of it, this new battery would be all but unbeatable. Tesla was content to buy cells with its proprietary chemistry from its suppliers, but it saw problems ahead. Tesla aims to grow at a consistent rate of 40 to 50% per year, and to do so, it will require an increasing number of batteries. Tesla's battery estimates indicated a mismatch between its battery cell suppliers' production limits and Tesla's internal demand for its vehicle and energy storage businesses. Tesla teams have been hard at work, purchasing and designing new technical solutions to achieve additional advancements in the battery cell format to solve this. Perhaps more importantly, Tesla used its knowledge in battery cell manufacturing, as well as its world-class manufacturing equipment capabilities, to completely reinvent the process from start to finish. Step change improvement in cell manufacturing. Tesla quickly expanded its efforts beyond simply developing and creating products as it sought higher economies in vehicle manufacturing. Designing the machine that creates the machine. Manufacturing is difficult, but Tesla's dedication led it to develop products that were easier to manufacture. This was first seen with the Model 3, and the work has continued with each iteration. When the time came to designing the new battery, Tesla went back to the very beginning. This reflects Musk's obsession with the first principles reasoning. He tries to begin every design, every discussion with the lowest common denominator, the simplest truth that connects our products to the minerals they are made of. After those have been defined and refined numerous times, an optimized design can be built. With the acquisition of battery and supercapacitor pioneers Maxwell Technology and Hebar Systems, Tesla established new ground truths in the battery world. Tesla learned its way by constructing the first gigafactory in Sparks, Nevada, by acquiring Grumman Automation, a producer of manufacturing equipment. Grumman quickly became the major developer for Tesla's Gigafactory 1's battery cell production lines, with the factory adding increasingly advanced production lines from Grumman as cell production capacity increased. Improving each of the basic components that form a battery was beneficial and resulted in improved efficiency in the Gigafactory 1. But Tesla saw the bigger picture, total integration. Drew Baglino unpacked the vision now being achieved at Tesla during the Battery Day event. Tesla's unwavering pursuit of vertical integration comes from the desire to eliminate inefficiencies and improve product sustainability. Tesla's vertical integration results in much-needed cost reductions, which will drive down the price of Tesla's goods over time. Form factor. One of the outcomes of these efforts is a new 4680 tabless cylindrical battery cell format, which offers a slew of performance, manufacturing, and cost advantages. As the name suggests, the new jumbo cell measures 46 millimeters in width and 80 millimeters in height. The larger jelly roll fits more active battery material into the casing, improving energy storage and power by 5 and 6 times respectively. When compared to the rest of the pack, the new form factor alone provides a 16% increase in range. In almost every way, the new tabless 4680 cells are fundamentally superior to cells with tabs. Even though they're larger, removing the tab allows electrons to move inside the cell much more easily than with the current 2170 cells. Improved chemistry. The new battery cells are not the result of a single change in cell size. The 4680 cells, like the numerous rewrites of Tesla Autopilot over the years, represent a fundamental rewrite of Tesla's battery cell history. Silicon is used in Tesla batteries today, but its physical properties make it difficult to use in larger quantities. When charged with lithium, silicon expands 4 times its original size. Because silicon is the second most abundant element in the Earth's crust, after oxygen, of course, it is a low-cost, easy-to-obtain commodity. In reality, sand is nothing more than silicone dioxide. To work around the rough edges of silicon, Tesla, perhaps unsurprisingly, began with raw silicon that immediately lowered the cost of silicon. And Tesla developed new chemistry to complement it. This is far less complicated than current processes and allows for a higher percentage of silicon to be used inside the cells. As a result, The cell is less expensive while also having a higher capacity. If this sounds like the ultimate win-win situation, you're right. That's one of the many reasons why Tesla CEO Elon Musk was ecstatic about otherwise tech-heavy battery day. Reimagining cathode production. According to Tesla, today's cathode production methods are based on historical chemistries and processes created in silos. Tesla, being Tesla, used a blank piece of paper to develop a strategy to optimize each phase from ore to cathode in order to minimize waste and cost. The simplified pictogram of an exceedingly sophisticated global supply chain extending from raw ore processing to finished cathode distribution is significantly less complicated. It is not only more streamlined, but it's also far less expensive and produces a lot less waste. Tesla's new high-nickel cathodes eliminate the need for cobalt. Cobalt is a great chemical anchor for cathode, but has some major drawbacks. Right off the bat, cobalt is toxic. The fewer toxic metals that humans mine, process, and use, the better. It's also increasingly difficult to ensure a sustainable source of cobalt, since the lion's share of the world's cobalt supply comes from a single country, the Democratic Republic of Congo. The country's government has not been the most stable, and investing hundreds of millions of dollars into an already corrupt system would not make conditions any better. Some human rights organizations coined the term conflict cobalt to describe how ethics can sometimes fall by the wayside. When all of the factors are considered together, cobalt, while beneficial in the battery cell, is also helpful to a company aiming to scale up battery production to 3 terawatt hours per year by 2030. By ditching cobalt in favor of a high nickel cathode, the cost of a cathode is reduced by 15% on a kilowatt per hour basis. Tesla's ability to design and manufacture cathodes from the ground up also gives a significant advantage in developing its own internal battery recycling systems. Overall, Tesla's work cathodes resulted in a process that reduces the processing cost by a whopping 76%. All of that is accomplished with significantly less equipment, resulting in a 66% reduction in capital expenditures for cathode production. The new method uses significantly less water than traditional methods, which is icing on the cake. In fact, the new process produces no wastewater. Tesla is incorporating all of these advancements into a new cathode manufacturing facility in North America. It will be located to reduce non-value-added travel for raw materials and intermediate products in the region. Improved thermal characteristics. The tabless design is the improvement that does the majority of the heavy lifting to enable the use of a larger form factor. By removing the tabs, the extra component reduces the internal resistance within the cell. Internal resistance leads to increased heat generation, a more complex manufacturing process, and higher costs. Tesla's new 4680 cell removes the internal tab instead of integrating the tab's function into the jelly roll itself, resulting in a clean, uniform appearance to the cell's end. Tesla basically laser-powered the existing foils and enabled dozens of connections in the active material through the shingled spiral. Eliminating the tab on each cell removes the thermal issue from the equation, allowing Tesla to choose the form factor with the lowest cost and the simplest manufacturing process. Focusing on the thermal advantages of Tesla's new 4680 cells tabless design, larger diameter cells can achieve thermal properties similar to those of smaller cells. In other words, they maintain the same temperature as smaller cells, allowing Tesla to pack more power into the same physical volume. Larger tabbed cells have historically struggled to dissipate heat at high charging rates. Tesla's new cell bucks the trend, charging nearly as fast as a smaller cell while providing all of the benefits of a larger cell. Tesla's combined the best of both worlds, completely disrupting the small but growing world of automotive battery manufacturing. The bottom line is that even though it'll take some time to produce the 4680 battery, it will be a win for Tesla and all of its customers as the battery provides more power, range, and effectiveness while significantly reducing the cost. So, that's it for today's video, guys. What do you think of Tesla's new 4680 battery? Will it be a game changer? Until next time, ciao!